Hour, your home for original reporting.
I'm Matt Piper in New York. There is a crucial meeting tonight to set up a House vote to formally hold Steve Bannon in contempt of Congress. The former Donald Trump ally, the committee says, has not been cooperating with their investigation of the Capitol insurrection. CBS's Chris Van Cleve is on Capitol Hill.
A finding of contempt of Congress by the committee investigating January 6th starts the process of Steve Bannon potentially facing criminal charges. But before that can happen, a majority of the House will have to vote to hold him in contempt. Speaker Pelosi will have to certify that result and transmit it to the Justice Department. The DOJ will do its own review before presenting it to a grand jury.
President Biden has been meeting with a host of Democrats today, trying to get them on board with his massive infrastructure and social spending bills. Congresswoman Pramila Jayapal says she feels optimistic that they will reach a deal.
We understand that the margins are slim, so we need to get there. And so I think it's fine for the president to have smaller meetings with different groupings of people. I think that's a good thing. It doesn't mean that we're not all talking to each other separately as well. So I think we're in a good place.
A scathing report out from the Navy today on the results of the investigation into last year's fire aboard one of its ships off San Diego that lasted 5 days and ultimately destroyed the $2 billion vessel. Correspondent David Martin has it.
During the overhaul, repeated failures allowed for the accumulation of significant risk and an inadequately prepared crew, which led to an ineffective fire response. Among the 36 individuals singled out for blame, either for their actions or for lack of oversight, were the ship's captain and five admirals. A 20-year-old seaman apprentice has been charged with setting the fire.
No one was seriously hurt when an airplane bound for Boston ran off a runway and burned near Houston. It traveled about 500 feet down that runway before the incident. Sergeant Stephen Woodard is with the Texas Department of Public Safety.
18 passengers aboard, 3 crew members to include 2 pilots and, of course, one attendee. The youngest child that we reported is 10 years old.
FBI agents are raiding 2 homes linked to Russian oligarch Oleg Deripaska. The New York and Washington, D.C. homes have seen agents going in and out all day. Deripaska has ties to the Kremlin and to Paul Manafort, the one-time chairman of Donald Trump's campaign. Oscar-winning songwriter Leslie Bricruz has died. His many hits include that one from Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. He also co-wrote Goldfinger for the James Bond franchise. Bricruz was 90 years old. The Dow gained 199. This is CBS News.
Well, that's today's news. Today's news. I didn't hear any good news, did you? I didn't think so. I guess it's all about perspective. The glass is half full. Well, as always, I want to thank you again for coming along with me on these Dashcam News Adventures. You know the drill. Peace, love, and all that hippie jazz. Bye-bye, everybody.